can grow. Human nature can be educated. It can also be contaminated by selfishness, mm-hmm. by aggressiveness, by revenge. Most people are not mean out of for amusement. Most people who are violent, most people who are aggressive, are simply acting in adult form what they learned as children.
Carl Menninger, MD, is chairman of the Board of Trustees of the Menninger Foundation in Topeka, Kansas. During an illustrious career spanning nearly 70 years, he has held such positions as founder and dean of the Menninger School of Psychiatry and distinguished professor of psychiatry at the University of Chicago. He has written books on such topics as The Human Mind, Man Against Himself, and The Vital Balance. His recognitions include the Sheen Award from the American Medical Association and the Presidential Medal of Freedom. One of the recurrent problems our society has had is that we continue over and over again to perpetuate violence as a solution to conflicts. What have you learned in your career that might be helpful to people struggling along with yourself these days to avert the course we are on?
Well, I think that the course we're on could be altered, but only if enough people believe what has been demonstrated, believe what we see coming, believe the wisest voices we hear all over the country, all over the world, for that, and do something about it.
Why are governments not responsive?
It's easy to say because they're the other party. Mm-hmm. But you might fear. But neither the Republicans or the Democratic parties have done enough to stop it. They could.
Mm-hmm. Do you think the answer is to be found in the voters?
Yes, of course. The people want to be saved, they'll have to save themselves. And they have to believe what they're told. Namely, that plans are being made for all the others to be destroyed, and that means for us to be destroyed. You can't have it one way. You can't shoot a shotgun without a kick. You can't make an aggressive blow without having a self-injurious reaction. Psychoanalysts and psychologists were studying that at the same time the atomic physicists were studying the nuclear disintegration and reintegration in Chicago 40 years mm-hmm. ago. For 40 years they've been studying ways to more effectively and controllably break down matter with a great release of energy, how to direct that energy and so forth. During that same period of time, psychoanalysts have been trying to understand the origins, distribute, and control of psychological energy. How do we control hate? Where does hate come from? We don't speak of violence, let's say hate.
Mm-hmm.
So far. Now, does the hate go into violence, or does it go into destructiveness, or does it go into some other kind of motivation? Suppose you hate somebody very much. You can do two or three. You can go and kill him. Mm-hmm. Let us say you could. You could write articles about him. You could scream at him. You could hit him. What else could you do? On the Sermon on the Mount, it was suggested that you could be kind to him, gentle him down, Mm-hmm. So I had a very disturbed patient come to me, thrashing his arms and waving his fists and so forth. I could say, well, get out of here, you rascal. I don't want you around here. I don't mm-hmm. like people that like you. He might come at me all the more. Mm-hmm. I might go at him all the harder. We might have a big fist fight here. What kind of performance is that? What I ought to do is to say, what's the matter, fellow? Who's mm-hmm. after you? What does you want? Who's been hurting you? What? How'd this get started? My hopes of gentling him down are going to be kind to him.
Mm-hmm.
But, and that's what the Sermon on the Mount said, but who pays attention to that? Who believes in loving their enemies or even being kind to them? Well, that's Jesus stuff.
Mm-hmm.
We were advised how to avoid this violence,
mm-hmm.
but not very many of us practice that technique. I don't think Mr. Reagan ought to say any criticisms of the Russians with anger. I think he ought to say, what's the trouble over there?
Mm-hmm.
Can't we have a talk about this? Not about limiting weapons. Let's talk about doing each other some favors. You folks really need more wheat. If you had a drought there several mm-hmm. years, what can you do about it? We don't want to see you suffer. You're human beings. We've got some wheat over there. And you've got some fine vodka. You've got some good things over there, haven't you? Well, yeah, we may have a few, but you Americans think we've got nothing but communism and dynamite. No, we want to understand you better. We want you to understand us. We're busy playing golf playing with computers. We're doing busy. We don't want to be stopped. We don't want to run, get our gun and start shooting at you.
Mm-hmm.
Well, we Russians thought you did. You talk like it, you know, and you place some guns over here in Europe or closer to us. You're going to shoot them at us, we suppose. We don't know exactly what we've done, but we hear you say it better be dead than red. Mm-hmm. We think you mean something terrible by that. What's red so bad? That's mm-hmm. our theory. What's your principle? Mm-hmm. Oh, we believe in democracy and capitalism and other things. What does that mean? Well, it means something a little different from everybody having the same amount. Well, let's compare the advantage. Let's discuss it. Oh, we can't discuss it. It's been discussed.
Why doesn't that dialogue occur?
Why doesn't it occur, I ask you? Why don't hundreds of our American, why don't our senators, some of them do go over there, there have been a number of very intelligent senators go over in groups, mm-hmm. look around in Russia, they come back with a different story than them, but the newspaper doesn't tell us anything about it. I don't know where the television's done its share of publicity.
Part of the problem is to listen to people who do have ideas about the way to a more peaceful world. But there's some part of our society that must block our willingness to do that. For example, if you came out with a new computer chip that would have a faster memory retrieval, that would be adopted very rapidly in our society.
That sounds good, I guess.
Why don't we adopt these very sensible ideas?
I don't know of any great organization that's given a grant for the production of such ideas. I think the Congress could, which has spent a good deal of money on mm-hmm. ammunition and such things, I think the Congress might consider giving let's say $100,000 prize or even a bigger one
mm-hmm.
for every usable idea contributed to the improvement of peace and the dispersal of violent intentions.
Mm-hmm.
You see, we're not only violent towards some people, But we're violent. Our intentions are more violent. We're planning right now to murder 200,000 people. I wouldn't want to participate in murdering one person, and you wouldn't either. Most people wouldn't. But we can participate with a group of war hoopers to plan for killing a whole bunch of them. And if you word it that way, it looks differently.
Mm-hmm. Does religion, as it's practiced in America, have a role?
Oh, sure, it's practiced many ways in America, but religion, there are religious impulses and religious programs in everybody, but they don't get directed, as I see it, they don't get directed very frequently to a place where they would be most effective. As I just said about the Sermon on the Mount. Suppose we advocate the Sermon on the Mount today. You're going to have a lot of people turn off the television. Say, well, I don't hear. That's nice, pious stuff. I've got to find out how to live. Mm-hmm. I've got to find out how to overcome my competitors. I've got to find out how to pay my taxes. I've got to find out how to eliminate. I've got to find out how to kill a few more Russians. We've got to kill all these Russians.
Mm-hmm.
Or they're going to kill us. It's just defensive. We're just threatening.
Mm-hmm.
We're not doing it. It's just defensive threatening. Mm-hmm. It is bluffing.
Mm-hmm. What would you hope that the religious leaders in America would do to enhance the possibilities for peace?
Well, I think they're doing the best. They're trying hard. Well, from this particular angle, I wish they were more concerned with this, with what you're concerned with, the destructiveness, the organized destructiveness of mankind. Right now, the suicidal destructiveness of our own nation, our people, our planet, I think it is, has been said dozens of times by wise men, that this planet may be in its last years, that we ourselves are going to bring about this terrible day. You know, in the mass there, the Dies Irae, the awful days of the fire, the ending. Now, people say, well, let's hope not, let's pray not, let's hope that something will turn up. Yes, you can. I want you to hope that. I want to hope that too. But I want to do more than hope. I want people to try to stop it while they can.
Mm-hmm.
You can prevent some suicides, you know. We psychiatrists try all the time to prevent suicides, and we succeed most of the time. I think we should try to prevent this earth suicide, this human attack on this other people and their counterattack on us. Now, if I were responsible for a church, for a congregation, for a parish, I think I'd be talking about this all the time.
Mm-hmm.
And I wish some of them felt inclined to just preach the Sermon on the Mount every Sunday.
Mm-hmm.
I don't think we can hear the Sermon on the Mount too often in our generation.
From someone who's had a lifelong interest in rehabilitation and working in the criminal justice arena, what insights have you gained that are relevant to understanding the current situation our society faces?
Well, most of us that are concerned with this scientifically are pretty discouraged. Because, the Sermon on the Mount isn't apply to them either very much.
Mm-hmm.
The Chief Justice of our highest court cries and calls and appeals every year, I was going to say, perhaps every day, to fellow lawyers and fellow workers in the field. We're not doing this the right way. We are not treating prisoners right. We're not stopping crime by our methods. Let's get better methods. Handle this subject differently. But it's very difficult to get the public on your side.
Mm-hmm.
Public hears about crowded prisons, and they may or may not realize that they've caused part of that by scaring the judges into doing anything less than sending everybody that they have a chance to jail.
Mm-hmm.
Some judges are afraid of the public shouts. Public says, pay them, make them pay their debts to society, take it out of them, and so on. They want to punish prisoners. We don't want to punish prisoners. Prisoners don't need punishment. We want them to keep those prisoners in a way, such a way that they won't hurt us.
Mm-hmm.
But they may grow, they may become better citizens. But the jail isn't going to do it.
Mm-hmm.
We may have to have them in jail because we're so afraid of them. But most of them we don't need to be afraid of. You know, most prisoners are not violent.
Mm-hmm.
Most crimes are not crimes of violence. But they help fill up the jails. The violent criminals and all the other gentle criminals, I'll call them gentle, they're mischievous, they're mean, they're dishonest, they're lots of other things, but they're not, for the most part, violent.
Mm-hmm.
To jam all these people together is just simply to say, here are all the bad people, throw them in hell or throw them anywhere, we don't care. Don't put them near us. Don't put your nice honor camp in our county. Don't try to have any educating or reforming or improving of human beings in our area, because we're afraid of these fellas.
Mm-hmm.
You keep them locked up in some other place. I don't know where the church people are in those counties. I don't know where the Sermon on the Mount people are. I don't know where the intelligent citizens are.
Mm-hmm.
Who know that that's the sort of thing. I don't know where the people that listen to Judge Berger are.
Mm-hmm.
They don't act as if they heard.
What is it about human nature that makes this kind of fear predominate over, in your view, a more rationed public interest?
When you say, what is there about it, you want me to name something? You know what there is about it. There's human nature about it. Human nature can improve, in my opinion. Human nature can grow. Human nature can be educated. It can also be contaminated by selfishness,
mm-hmm.
by aggressiveness, by revenge. Most people are not mean for amusement. Most people who are violent, most people who are aggressive, are simply acting in adult form what they learned as children from their parents, from their homes.
So the crucible of much of the violence is in the family.
Is the family. There's no doubt about that. All this scandal about Freud in the papers the last few months, in the Atlantic mm-hmm. Monthly and all these other, all that business, saying Freud was too naive to believe what he heard. Freud heard about the meanness of adults, of mm-hmm. parents to children. Freud heard it. And at first he believed it, and he said, people can't be that bad.
Mm-hmm.
The children must have imagined it. The children don't imagine the mistreatment,
mm-hmm.
doctor. Children are being mistreated this very morning in this very community, in your community, his community. They're being mistreated, they're being sexually abused, they're being punished cruelly, and they're being ruined, and little criminals are being here and there manufactured.
And the seeds for violence in generations to come are being laid. This is a terrible block to achieving peace. How would you advise those people who care about the family in America to work to make the family a source of the positive parts of human nature rather than of violence?
Well, now my recipe is vengeance is the worst disease in the world. Revenge is an epidemic, like herpes or like infections of other kind.
Mm-hmm.
We have to try to cure it.
How would you start with the family? There's got to be a way.
I would try to accept the fact that the best we know is that punishment does no good.
Mm-hmm.
It's expensive. It's cruel. It's sometimes satisfying to the punisher. It does the punished person no permanent good, but makes him postpone the retaliation. You see, the Supreme Court encourages the schools to punish children if they wanted to, whip them if they wanted. Did you know that? Mm-hmm. Did you know that our Supreme Court, I think I'm using the right words, said it was not illegal for the teachers to give corporal punishment if they felt it was deserved or needed.
Mm-hmm.
Some such phrase like that. See, I don't think any teachers ought to teach by whipping.
Mm-hmm.
The Supreme Court does. I think Mr. Reagan does, doesn't he? I mean, he said the other day he wanted them to go back to old-fashioned methods to enforce the teachers. The idea was to defend the teacher herself.
Mm-hmm.
Of course, she ought to be defended. But I think a lot of people took that to mean spank some of these children or whip some of these children.
And in your insight,
I'm against that.
The reason you're against it is it sows the seeds of later violence.
I do think so.
A fundamental message you would give educators is to make schools a non-punishing place.
Well, it isn't only my message. I'm not the first one that said, don't hurt people, be kind to them. Love them. And the teachers that are loved and remembered forever are the ones that love the children.
Mm-hmm.
Don't teach them by slapping their face. They teach them by going over the essay a second time or a third time.
From a lifetime of working with people with mental illness, of trying to help them recover and lead more productive lives, what insights have you gained that would be helpful to achieving an enduring peace?
Well, you see, we psychiatrists began taking care of those patients to get the people rid of them. People said, we've got an uncle living in our house and we can't stand him. He's just mad as a hatter and he disturbs all of us. And what'll we do with him? Well, the sheriff won't take him because he hadn't done anything wrong. The hospital won't take him because he doesn't seem sick. Who'll take him off of our hands?
Mm-hmm.
Psychiatrists began being sort of sheriffs, if you like, or somebody to help people with distressing character. And we began to look for ways to put those people out of their distress and their pain. It would act that way if they weren't hurting.
Mm-hmm.
Skyrig began by helping control people. And then we learned we got better drugs and we got better hospitals, and we had better methods of handling. And then we began to talk to them kindly instead of saying, well, shut up now, don't do that again. Instead of that, we'd say, well, what is the matter? What worries you more? Who hurts your feelings?
Mm-hmm.
And that makes a very different reaction from the
sure
sick person.
It's So taking the time to listen to feelings of anguish in other people, of being concerned with their perspective.
Psychologists began to study the various intricacies of the patterns of the, what they say, you know, is I'm lonely, I'm scared, I'm frightened.
Mm-hmm.
I want to belong to somebody or something. I want to be liked, I want to be needed.
Mm-hmm.
Well, the psychologists have found various ways in which those wants can be gratified. And we put them into operation in the hospital.
And those basic ways of treating people humanely are for you an important way to begin to help people.
An essential way, yeah.
An essential way of helping people be more peaceful. I'd like to close by asking you to return to a theme that has been recurrent in your writings over the decades, and that is that people are capable of positive change.
Oh, of course. I take that so for granted that I scarcely understand the question.
How would you want us all to change as a society in order to achieve a more peaceful world?
Well, I put a taboo on vengeance and revenge, retaliation. And even if it's called patriotism or called valor or called standing up for yourself, all of those words, I'm trying to get rid of vengeance.
Mm-hmm.
That kid cries again, I'll smash his face in for him. That's nothing but revenge, you know. Because
mm-hmm.
the child cried and disturbed the father's peace. Well, you say most gentlemen don't do it like, don't do it. I know you don't. Most people don't. But they do other forms of retaliation.
Mm-hmm.
You do. I do. We mustn't do it.
Dr. Menninger, thank you for sharing with us today your insights into the way to a more peaceful world.